CBS just made major change to NYC terrorists' photo they broadcasted after 8 people were killed by him. And once again we see the fake news media pulling shenanigans instead of reporting the news. On Halloween night, an Islamo-Nazi terrorist by the name of Saiflo Saipov, who just happens to be a 29-year-old immigrant from the Muslim Mecca known as Uzbekistan, murdered 8 people in a truck attack in Manhattan just steps away from the World Trade Center location. Of course, the far-left media outlet CBS News released a photo of the Islamic terrorist after his arrest. It appears to be an image of his Florida drivers. And once again we see the fake news media pulling shenanigans instead of reporting the news. On Halloween night, an Islamo-Nazi terrorist by the name of Saiflo Saipov, who just happens to be a 29-year-old immigrant from the Muslim Mecca known as Uzbekistan, murdered 8 people in a truck attack in Manhattan just steps away from the World Trade Center location. Of course, the far-left media outlet CBS News released a photo of the Islamic terrorist after his arrest. It appears to be an image of his Florida driver's license. Saiflo looks like a bearded Caucasian in the CBS photo. In fact, he looks as white, or even more than most of us who are of European descent. But this is what he really looks like compared to what CBS tried to make us believe. CBS News is now being accused of photoshopping Saipov's photo, which is 100% obvious if you compare the picture they showed to the real picture. And this isn't the first time mainstream media has done this in order to protect Muslims. A lone gunman intentionally picked the Fort Lauderdale airport today to fly into and open fire on innocent travelers this afternoon, claiming 5 lives and injuring 9 more victims of his wrath before he ran out of ammunition. As news broke of this attack, the liberal media pounced on their report of it, namely, CNN, who had a photo claiming to be the shooter, Santiago Esteban, with something seriously wrong, and it was as intentional on their part as the attack was for Esteban. Seen from Fort Lauderdale shooting and man CNN wrongfully claimed to be shooter Santiago Esteban. The Fort Lauderdale airport was a perfect target for this terrorist who could have flown into Miami, but he'd be met with 10 times the number of authorities there considering how many law enforcement agencies are on hand to stop the flow of drugs into the country. Presumably aware of this fact, Esteban picked a Florida terminal at a different airport with the least resistance. Now, one of the biggest culprits on spin, CNN wants you to believe that he's a crazed, white, military psychopath, not a Muslim or any other liberal love child. While breaking the news about the shooter's identity, they seem to have doctored the photo of who they said was Esteban, showing a man who is clearly dark-skinned, but in CNN's picture for broadcast, this man appears as white as they come, as the Gateway pundit pointed out. But before or after, he's still allegedly not the right Santiago Esteban, according to the International Business Times. This is no coincidence. It's simply what the news filtering network is known for: twisting, lying, or completely making things up. They had to do something to make everyone forget about the racist attack on an innocent Trump supporter, tortured by a foursome of Barack Obama's nastiest hood rats, so they made a presumably innocent man look like a white guy to redirect everyone's attention back on their divisive agenda, not even using the person's picture responsible for this attack. Not only is this guy allegedly not him and not white, the real shooter is probably not conservative, didn't vote for Trump, and likely had a secret agenda of his own in joining our military. As you can clearly see by the article above, this isn't the first time, nor will it probably be the last time they pull an evil stunt like this. It has been reported that Saipov entered the United States under the Diversity Visa Program back in 2010, which is the very program that was written and promoted by the New York Senator Chuck Schumer. The same senator who has promoted gun control multiple times so we law-abiding American citizens aren't able to defend ourselves against the garbage politicians like he himself let into our country. It's now time to close our borders and see who the hell is already in here. Once we figure that out, maybe we can once again continue to let people in. It's not a right to come into the United States, but it is a right for citizens of this country to have safety inside our borders. To know that we can take our kids out trick-or-treating without the fear of a terrorist from a third-world Islamic cesspool attacking us. And the mainstream media, along with globalist politicians, need to stop lying to us. Politicians created this mess and the media has been complicit. They don't care. It's not like any politician's loved one has ever been lost to terrorism. Plus the George Soros payday is great.